What's up guys, it's Hashirthyami back again with another tutorial, and in this one we are going to start with basics of Figma. So I'm starting this series, Figma for beginners, where I'm going to start with the basics, like first going through the main interface of Figma. How can we create different files? How can we play around with FigJam files? How can we import files and why do we do that? Then we are going to go through how to create files and manage them and make them look beautiful. And also in this whole series we are going to observe and go through each individual tool that Figma has to offer, and then you know, talk about it in detail. So if you are new to Figma, if you are new to UI UX design or product design or whatever, this tutorial series is perfect for you to start with. Alright, so let's begin. Okay, so usually if you start Figma first time, you might not see all these files on your recents. So right now I have selected recents, so it is going to show all the files that you have been working on, and they are going to be present here. If you want any of these files to not occur here, you just have to right click it and remove from recent, but it won't remove it from your directory and it will still be in your Figma file. Okay, so then there are drafts. We've got community. In community section you can explore a lot of pre-made files and plugins and all that that you can see right over here, that are basically created or published by people like me, people like you, and you know, anyone can do that and publish assets that can be used by any other designer, even by you. So if you want to install a new plugin, you just have to go to this plugin tab, search the plugin name, and you can install that plugin. Whoops, ignore that. My internet might not be working right now, but yeah. Okay, it's back. So here you can see a list of plugins that you can use that can help you design some really cool stuff on your Figma file. Also, it can help you organize or do a lot of things. You can try it out for free, install these plugins and use them, and some of them are paid, but you don't have to worry about that because right now it's just a basic tutorial. So that's all the things that the community has to offer for you. Let's go back to my interface. All right, so right at the top you can see a notification tab where all the notifications are going to appear. Obviously here you can switch your profiles and settings and all that, and then we've got this section for teams. So if you have created a team or you are in a team, then it is going to appear right here. Alright, so now these three sections are for, one is for a design file, the other one is for FigJam file, and then the import file. Import file allows you to import a different file that is present on your PC. It can be a sketch file as well. So if you have a sketch file that you want to open in Figma, you would have to press this button, browse that file, and then open it up in Figma. Figma will do all the transferring of the file for you, so you don't have to worry about that. Then we have new FigJam file. This is just a whiteboard where you have the opportunity to design and sketch the ideation of any product. So that's for that. Then we have a new design file button. Let's continue with this for now. So if I press this, you will enter into a new file which is untitled for now. Let's call it tutorial 101 for now. Alright, so when you enter into a new file, you can see that it says it is saved in drafts. Now why is that? Okay, so to transfer that file into a team or into a project, you would have to select this drop down and then move to project. So until and unless that file is saved into a project or moved to a project, that file would be saved in your draft folder. Don't have to worry about that. If a file is present in draft folder, it doesn't mean that it is not going to be saved automatically. Figma would do that for you. You don't have to worry about that. It's just an indication that this file doesn't belong to any team or project. Okay, So let's create a team and then transfer this file into that team. If I want to create a new team, then I would have to go to this create new team. Let's name it Tutorial Army. How does that sound? Create team is going to ask you if you want to add collaborators. I don't have anyone right now, so I'm going to skip that for now. Then it will offer you the plans. Now we have starter plan, professional, and organization. Okay, so for teams specifically, Figma doesn't allow that much features in starter pack. So for starters, you don't really go with teams in Figma. You would rather work on your individual files that are saved in drafts, and then you can add people in it that can only view that file. So if you want to make or allow people to edit that file as well, then you would have to go with the professional plan, because in professional plan you can buy all the features for one specific team and then move the projects in that specific team. And then there is this organization plan, where you can have multiple teams and a library, and all the other features are also listed here, but organization plan is the best out there for Figma. So for now, I'm not gonna waste any money on this one. So let's just start with choose a starter. So there you go. So if you have a team, there can be different projects inside a team. Right now, this first project is right here. I just pressed this button and it got me into this into that project. So the first project is named as team project. If I want to add a new project in this team, I would have to click this button, but right now it's not going to allow me to do that because I haven't purchased any plan. But that's how you do it. So inside a team there can be different projects, and inside one project, if I click on it, there can be multiple files. And to create a new file inside a team, I would have to press this button, which would allow me to create a new file. So let's get rid of that for now, because I don't really want to do anything here. Let's delete this. Now the file that we had just created in drafts, I would want to move this to Tutorial Army Team Project. And boom, you can see that now the name of draft folder is changed to Team Project, and my file that I just created, Tutorial 101, lies inside that team project. Okay, alright, so this tutorial series is going to be short and precise for each individual video. So for this one, that's it. In the next one, I'm going to explain all these tools and all the properties that you can use inside one Figma file, and also how to, you know, make them organized. So yeah, see you in the next one. Bye.